The first idea I want to discuss is the Beringia timeline. I disagree with the idea that there was a mass exodus across Beringia. I believe the Amerindians followed prey back and forth across Beringia, likely making many trips in a single lifespan. Trace Dominguez with DNews states, the accepted theory claims Beringia existed for 27,000 years, and the Amerindians first crossed Beringia not more than 23,000 years ago. If, as the theory states, Amerindians crossed Beringia not more than 23,000 years ago, how does one explain carbon-dated evidence presented by Judith Nies that contradicts this timeline? 28,000-year-old remains of hearth charcoal were found on Santa Rosa Island in California. 27,000-year-old caribou scraper was found in western Alaska. Multiple tools were found that are over 25,000 years old in the Sandia Mountains of New Mexico. The second point is that the New World was diverse. There were four factions: Natives, French, Spanish, and English. Natives inhabited the continent. Although they lacked a written language, they had a complex social hierarchy. They were culturally diverse and had different languages and religious beliefs. They held the view that no man owned the land, and it was for everyone. The French Huguenots infiltrated from the north, fleeing religious persecution. They colonized for individual freedom, not exploitation, and they lived peaceably along with the natives. Spanish conquistadors exploited native land and people for gold, glory, and God by any means necessary in the New World. They committed atrocities against all factions in the New World. English colonized for privateering and industrial ventures. Heavy reliance upon the natives led to poor relations. They are the first people to use disease as a weapon. With so many factions on the same land, conflict and war ensued. In 1775, before the fighting was over, Thomas Jefferson planted the seed of English independence from Britain with his book, A Summary View of the Rights of British America. In 1776, Jefferson, along with other founders, wrote the Declaration of Independence. It's essentially reasons why the English wanted to separate from Britain. The French began to supplement the English Continental Army in 1777, after the Battle of Saratoga, where the Continental Army encircled British General John Burgoyne's soldiers, forcing them to surrender. In 1783, the Treaty of Paris was signed, and the New World no longer belonged to any faction other than its inhabitants. The United States was born, and in 1788, a 33rd degree Master Mason by the name of George Washington became the first President of the United States.